anything like me, you're waiting for the next Zelda game to come out. And if you're anything like, this guy, you're waiting for the next game of Team Ico's to be announced. What if there is something to tie us over until then? The Girl and the Robot is a game by Flying Carpet Games, and is currently in alpha. Keyword there, alpha. Now before you go asking, no, they didn't ask me to do this, and no, I didn't get a leaked version of the game illegally. You can actually buy the alpha for $9 American and get the full game upon its release, Minecraft style. Let's talk about the game, shall we? First thing to note is, it is alpha. So bugs are going to show up. On my first playthrough of the game, I found myself walking on thin air near the end of the alpha, which was a random glitch, I'm sure, but the terrain tag should be checked, here. The game has you controlling two characters, the girl and the robot. Enough said. The girl is used for platforming and the robot for combat, and they're both used for solving the puzzles. When walking around, you're set to strafing, almost like it was at a first-person perspective at some time in development. Holding shift or the X button will have you perform a run. You can actually steer yourself in directions while running. This makes movement a bit better to deal with. This is also the do everything button. This leads to the game not deciding what it wants to do. In terms of jumps, which only the girl can do, you lose all momentum while landing. And it's very clunky, really, like classic Castlevania style. The robot is very combat oriented. In fact, that's the only way you can attack. You use the triggers to attack with a sword or a bow. Everything is linked to your HP, so the more movements you do with the robot, the lower your HP gets. Again, everything is still pretty sluggish, but the idea behind them is so interesting. I hope they really fix them up for the final game. The puzzles are interesting and simple, but I feel like that later on in the game, it will have more challenging puzzles that challenge Zelda gamers and all of us. The visuals look beautiful. Even for a pre-alpha, it looks stunning. It reminds me a lot of Skyward Sword's palette and look, which that game was stunning in multiple ways. But all in all, The Girl and the Robot is a great game. I can't wait to play and see the final game in action. There are some problems, and the alpha is pretty short, but for $9 for a concept now and the full game later, you really can't go wrong. You can buy the game at Flying Carpet Games' website and also vote for it for Steam Greenlight. Links are in the description.